Very good afternoon. Today we'll discuss about bioindicator. Okay. What is bioindicator? Anyone? What is bioindicator? Or indicator species?
Sir, any living species which indicate the pollution in the particular area.
Okay. Anyone else?
Sir, it is an all living organism जो कि किसी भी ecosystems के morphology या physiology के का मतलब idea देता हो.
कुछ specific criteria को indicate करता है. That is indicator species. Either it is pollution. Or it is over phytoplankton, or it is productivity, or it is pathogen, either it is disease, anything, कोई भी organism और उस situation को indicate करता है, that will called as indicator species. If the biological situation indicated by any organism, that called as bioindicator. An indicator species or bioindicator is any organism that may signal a change occurring within an ecosystem, habitat, or location. Okay. Any example can anyone tell? बहुत सारे example है bioindicator का.
सर microalgae जो water quality को बताएगा.
हाँ microalgae example.
Lichen sir.
हाँ lichen okay. Fisheries में बॉयज में से कोई बोलो
जिम्नोडिनियम स्पीशीज सर जो कि वो मॉस्किटोज को करता
बॉयज में से कोई नहीं है वीरेंद्र
यस सर
हाँ बोलो भाई
नहीं पता है
हाँ
नहीं पता है
नहीं पता है एग्जाम में तो लिखे थे
क्या सर
फ्रेजिलेरिया ओसिनिका आया था ना
बोल रहे हैं
और कोई ओके द ऑर्गेनिज्म व्हिच रिप्रेजेंट द ओवरऑल फिजिकल केमिकल एंड बायोलॉजिकल नेचर ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर इकोसिस्टम इज कॉल्ड एज बायो इंडिकेटर बाय लुकिंग एट ए स्पीसीज देयर प्रेजेंस एब्सेंस और अबंडेंस इन एन एरिया It may be possible to draw conclusion about the health of larger ecosystem and how it is changing. The change, any changing in an ecosystem and its present situation, or if it is determined by in the presence or absence of any organism, then it's called as bioindicator or indicator species. Another term is there biomonitoring. Biomonitoring means that process in which the analytical instrument is used, that is plant and animals. Or their fragments that provide continuous real-time information. If we give any test organism or any test animal to a particular area and to check its present situation, it is called as active biomonitoring. Suppose we'll add some bioluminescent organism to any organ, any environment, and see some presence of some chemical is determined by the bioluminescence feature of that organism, then it is called as active. And if it is will not give any organism, add any organism, and the presence of that particular organism itself denote the situation, it is called as passive biomonitoring. Bioindicator or biomonitoring are similar terms. When you will actively add something, then it is called as active biomonitoring. What are the properties? They are the good indicator ability. They have some good indicator. That means they are present must indicate. They are abundant. They are common. Their biology are well studied. They are easy and cheap. And they are commercially or economically important. That is that species already harvested for other purposes. Okay. what are the basic prerequisites? That is the availability, that should be available, that should be sensitive to any situation, sedentary, capability, hardy structure, that means they can tolerate the situation, small and easily cultivable, indigenous or representative. They are the prerequisite. There are three types of classification is there. One is based of aim of the indicator. According to that, it is compliance indicator, diagnosis indicator, early warning indicator, accumulation indicator. These are the terms they have give some. If it is according to the aim of the indicator, these are the examples. These are the groups. Based on the applications, they are environmental. If it is environmental situation, if they are indicating, that is called an environmental indicator. If the ecological situation it is indicated, then it is called as ecological indicator. And if the biodiversity indicates, that called as biodiversity indicator. But the main classification that was given by International Union of Biological Science, that is IUBS, it is the microbial indicator, plant indicator, animal indicator, and cell biology and genetics indicator. Okay, please note down these things. Based on IUB, there are four types of indicator. If the question came, then please write the definition. What are the criteria? What are the characteristics? And some examples of bioindicator organism in each groups. In microbial system, what are the bioindicator? In plant system, what are the bioindicator? In animal system, what are the bioindicator? Okay, please note down these things. Microbial indicators. Microorganisms can be used as indicator of aquatic or terrestrial ecosystem. They are found in large quantities. Example, E. coli are fecal contamination and sewage pollution. They are the, if E. coli, Escherichia coli is there, that indicate the fecal contamination or sewage pollution. What is sewage? Next, Streptococcus and Enterobacter. They are also the indicator of fecal contamination. 303 is the indicator of oil pollution. Spirillum is an example of industrial pollution. Okay. These examples you have to write. Microbial indicators, kaun-kaun se example hai? Then plant indicator kya hai? Then animal indicator kya hai? What is sewage? Anyone?
Sir, the waste material comes from the home.
From our household purpose, the whatever waste generated from our household, that is called as sewage. Okay. That things I am telling now. The bacteria that indicates, that is active bioindicator, that is we add the Vibrio to any organism and to the water body to see whether the toxin is present. If the toxin is present, that affects the quality or amount of light emitted by the bacteria. Okay. It will, their cell metabolism will disturb and they will emit light. Okay. That is active biomonitor. Next, the plant indicators. The presence or absence of certain plant or other vegetative life in an ecosystem can provide important clues about the health of the environment. The examples are lichens. Lichens are the algae and fungi living symbiotically. They have to live together to survive. Lichens can live in extreme condition, but they hate pollution. The cleaner the air, the bigger and more elaborative the lichens will be present. Lichens are attached organism, whether it is algae or fungi, in any attached with any substrate. If the water quality is good, their growth will be high. If the water pollution is there, then the quantity of lichen will decrease. The macrophytes are Sagittaria, Eichornia growth is there where heavy metal pollution is there, because Eichornia is a absorbent of heavy metal pollution. If you will go East Kolkata wetland, there is any static water body, is Eichornia will be present. Okay. Lambda indicates heavy metal pollution. Sagittaria growth in eutrophic area. Seaweeds also accumulate the metals. Example, Fuca species. Okay. These examples you have to write. Animal indicators kya hai? Cladocerans, that is Diaptomas, Daphnia, Moina, they grow in acid condition. Daphnia longiremis is growth in eutrophic condition, whereas the copepod growth in thermal pollution. Where thermal pollution will be there the abundance of copepod will be high. Rotifers are generally found in polluted and high chlorine water area. Where the water is polluted and their chlorine content is high, there you will get the Brachyonas species. That is seawater pollution. If seawater pollution is there, Capitella capitata, one species is there, that indicates that polychaete, that indicates the seawater pollution is there. In Sagitta indicates the presence of oceanic water, movement of oceanic water from one ocean to another ocean. The diatom Fragilaria oceanica, an indicator species of oil sardine, Sardinella longiceps. Benthos are very prominent in polluted area. The gastropods, mollusks, polychaetes, they all indicate industrial and sewage pollution. Filter feeders such as bivalves tend to concentrate the metals in their gills because they are filter feeder and other tissues. Any polluted water, if you take the soil, you will find so many gastropod species are there. Gastropods and polychaete one will be dominant in polluted soil. Fishes are also an indicator species. The barbs, that is Danio, Minnows, they stay in good water quality area. If the water quality will deteriorate, they will die. If the pollution is there, drastic deterioration in their population, because they are highly sensitive. The barbs and minnows, they are the indicator of fresh water, good water quality regions. Okay. These are some examples which metals are found in which organisms. Mammals, because mammals are the topmost predator in the food chain, there also bioaccumulation is there, and we can find heavy metal. If it is polluted with heavy metal, then by estimating the gut content of the mammals, we can easily tell that the area is highly polluted with heavy metal pollution. Okay. Bioindicators have a remarkable potential in forecasting of disaster, prevention of pollution, exploration and conservation of natural resources, all aiming at a sustainable development with minimum destruction of the biosphere. Because here we have to do nothing, we have to just see the presence or absence of any organism without disturbing the ecosystem. Bioindicator can be applied in predicting the impact of anthropogenic activity, particularly pollution, and predicting the environmental change in a timely manner. Okay. Okay, students. Thank you. If any question is there, then please ask. Otherwise, I will end today's class. Okay. Thank you. I am ending today's class.